Now it's time for today's focus on the programme. And from 1972 until 1993, more than 300 tonnes of chlordecone was sprayed on Guadeloupe and Martinique's banana plantations. Now it is a highly toxic pesticide. And even though it is 25 years now since farmers stopped using it, it's still generating health and environmental crisis in the French West Indies. Today, the two islands have the highest rate of prostate cancers in the world, and premature births there are four times higher than the national average. Our correspondents Edward Hayward and Celine White report. Locals say despite ample scientific evidence, the French government has ignored the impact the pesticides have had.
With 80,000 tons of the fruit exported each year, Martinique's banana trade is key to driving its economy. But the business has come at a high cost. Banana plantations are accused of spreading poison deep in the land and water of Martinique.
We're in the middle of a banana plantation where they've been using an organochlorine pesticide called chlordecone since 1972. It's an ecological catastrophe and a health disaster because 92% of the population has been shown to have traces of chlordecone in their bloodstream.
Louis Boutrin, a lawyer from Martinique, was the first person to link the toxicity of chlordecone to the effect it was having on people's health. As early as 2007, he exposed the slow poisoning of Martinique's human population.
For decades, our drinking water was full of chlordecone. The food was contaminated. That's just what happened here.
In 1976, the U.S. banned the use of chlordecone after scientific studies proved it was dangerous. But banana plantations in the French West Indies continued to use it until 1993. The authorities' lack of action had serious consequences for the population. According to a study from the French Institute of Health, years of exposure to chlordecone have increased the number of prostate cancer patients on the island. Martinique currently has one of the highest number of prostate cancer cases in the world.
I was a farmer at the Casapolo plantation, and I developed cancer because of the level of chlordecone in my blood.
Francois Veillon is one of the 10,000 farmers who worked without any protection on the banana plantation for years.
Nobody told us it was this serious. We know it's poisonous and we should have been more cautious. But you know, employers don't tell us those things.
A few farmers' rights associations have tried to take legal action to help victims, but they were not successful. Not a single complaint has led to a trial. But Josiane Jos-Pelage refuses to give up. Working in a maternity ward, she saw all too well the impact of chlordecone on the population.
I worked here for 7 years. I was a pediatrician in this ward, and at that time we saw so many premature babies. There were a lot of premature births.
In 2010, she commissioned a successful study to prove the correlation between pesticide poisoning and premature births. Yet nothing has changed.
Of course there are studies, but the moment you move away from the theoretical side and look at the actual support that's available for pregnant women, then we hit a wall of denial.
Currently, the government does not ensure health support for pregnant women poisoned by chlordecone, even though it has been proven that the pesticide has contaminated a part of the food chain in Martinique, including the seafood. Fishing has been banned in 33% of Martinique's coastal waters because of chlordecone pollution. This has had catastrophic consequences for the local fishermen.
Fishing is banned all across this area. A lot of older fishermen now suffer from depression, and many young people were unable to develop their activity. There have been many tragedies because there's a family context to this. And when there was some support from the state, it was so pitiful that many were not able to keep on working properly.
In an effort to help fishermen diversify their activity, the French government launched the third chlordecone plan in 2014. But of the 1.5 million euros allocated, only 50 fishermen out of a total of 506 were able to receive help.
People need to know every time they eat a banana in France or anywhere else in the world that bananas kill. They've killed in Martinique and we're still under the diktat of the banana here.
There is currently no effective way to get rid of the claudicone from the soil. Regardless, Abdul Jarreh continues to grow fruits on the contaminated land. He is part of the new strategy to encourage fruit exports, the Zero Claudicone Label, introduced by the Regional Natural Park of Martinique. Fruits that grow above the ground are considered toxic-free since claudicone cannot travel through tree trunks.
The plants that I grow don't contain any traces of claudicone, and several laboratories have confirmed this. It is possible for us to get our act together, and it is my earnest wish that we ensure that future generations are guaranteed products that won't damage their health.
A state visit by President Emmanuel Macron in September 2018 has raised the hope of Martinique's farmers. For the first time, a French president has publicly acknowledged claudicone poisoning in the French West Indies, and he has asked for a report to explain the magnitude of the contamination. If no viable solution is found soon, Martinique's land will stay soiled by this poisonous pesticide for centuries to come.
China has showed off some of the most advanced weaponry in the world with a huge military parade in Beijing. In a full display of power for its rivals, they've unveiled a new range of high-tech military weapons for the very first time. One of those is this intercontinental ballistic missile. It can carry up to 10 nuclear warheads and can reach the United States in as little as 30 minutes. With a range of 9,000 miles, it can fly further than any other nuclear missile in the world. Overhead, a new strategic bomber designed to project power far into the Pacific Ocean, and China's first stealth jet fighters. But the showstoppers were the weapons of the future. There was the Sharp Sword combat drone, an unmanned aerial combat vehicle that could make piloted strike fighters obsolete. This supersonic reconnaissance drone, designed to locate American aircraft carriers far out in the Pacific Ocean. And a hypersonic missile, a sleek dart that flies at more than five times the speed of sound, so fast it can penetrate all existing missile defenses used by the West.
I just want to ask the question, when will enough be enough? When will the people of Portsmouth and Dominicana whole say enough is enough?
Because I'm the Labour Party that is in charge of all the finance and everything, because they are in power right now. It seems like only when election coming on is time to renew the expiry date, that is when they're really doing things. I have a lot of people that struggling, a lot of people that do have it, have a lot of people that I know that do have.
So yeah, fellas, I mean, on a serious note, we gotta stand up now and we have to recognize something is wrong, you know, in the structure. In terms of, I mean, I'm not into the politics thing at all, but at the same time, I'm not a naive person. There's a lot of shit going on. Right, I'm talking to my DA fellow crew, so I don't have to hold back my tongue, although I really want to make sure that, you know, I say this in a peaceful way. But fellas, it's time to rise. It's time for us to take this where we supposed to have been already.
Everything we do in Casabros is all about the government paying us a little money to do it, to get it done. That doesn't make no sense at all. Because what about my other fans, my other friends? My colleagues and them that go to school and finish school and doesn't have a job, don't know what is the next move, what are they going to do? I mean, come on, man, if you're not supporting the Labour Party government, then there's nothing for you. You have nothing.
I mean, it's just a shame on that organization, because then they are the one you have to hold accountable for the responsibility of governance, development, education, health, and even agriculture so far, because everywhere my eyes could fall is abandoned. That alone is a problem. Come on. That's a nature island. What we supposed to represent nature.
Now what? We just accepting. We just sit back, we chill, and we waiting for what? speak up, people. Maybe Dominica really need a protest, and I'm calling on the young people. Young people, just a whole bunch of you young people, just go and gather on the Bayfront. Just go, don't let no party. It's not about workers, it's not about labor, it's not about nothing. Let them know, let them see that you're tired, you're ready for change.
Young people, this is our time. Take it from me, this is our time to bring back our country. This is our time. Trust me, don't let that opportunity pass us by. Do not let that opportunity pass us by.
Some Dominicans back home are afraid to speak out because their entire life is based on a decision of a politician.
Yes, sir.
No more will this be. We have to be able to live in an economy where everyone is self-sufficient and not relying on the signature of a government official.
That's why it's our time, the generation that born from 1980 to year 2000, in between that, it's our time to fight and to liberate our country. You understand? It's our time to fight and liberate our country.
Because it's the people who put you there. Or they can come out and say, I run things in Dominica. No, my boy, you don't run things, my boy. Because it's not you that vote in yourself. It's the people who have to vote you to put you into power. You don't run things, my boy. The people run things. And people need to get that in their head. We run things, not you guys. We put you guys there to run the country business. And you are running crooked.
Hey, let me tell you now. I don't know your Dominica. I really don't know what we're going through. But I can tell you, that is can never be the right way, my brother. Never. Never. Chano, we have to do better than that, my brother.
The police, men, that know right from wrong, stop peeping in the window, open the door and come out. The teachers, who know they are victimized and cannot get an increase, I know that his money for cool-out is making ding-dong in Dominica. Stop peeping in the window, open the door and come out. The business sector, stop the window looking and the whispering and come out and talk for truth to power. The Christian community, the Catholic Church, all of all you that hide in and when all you within, all you cross it, all you talking, oh, let the Prime Minister know he's wrong so he can correct it.
Self-explanatory why these people want to stay in power, right? But you, the people, reflect on your health, right? You've lost your wealth, and I'm not even talking about financial wealth. I'm talking about what Dominica is, Dominica can be, and what it was in terms of the deep history that's been stolen, right? We have to open up our eyes and our mind and see what's going on. Right? We're sitting there screaming for politics while our family and friends are dying.
No, in Dominica, we just move back, we laid back, the people not talking, everybody just take whatever they get. Oh, there's no ambulance, or there's no fire truck, the fire truck gonna put out a fire, there's a hose, there's holes in the hose of the fire truck, but we have money all over the place doing all kind of nonsense, but we cannot get basic 101 healthcare in check. Ladies and gentlemen, that is unacceptable. Seriously. It's 2019. Let's get to the program. Let's not be hypocrites and let's not pretend and try to fool people.
You know, there's an evil force in Dominica and it starts from the head. You understand? It starts from the head. When the PM can tell people to throw water, hot water on people, people will do anything, man. Once the head is telling you to do that, them people in Dominica will just take from what they had to say and they can do anything and get away.
So we cannot have those kind of people like Isaac representing people. It's not a joke. I expect it better from him.
Because people, it's not easy. It's not easy when you have a leader.
All of them white.
When you see a leader intriguing violence in a country, a humble servant country like Dominica, loving people and turning them into beasts, to burn people at their doorstep, this is not easy.
People need to stand for their rights in Dominica. People need to begin to speak out. You understand what I'm saying? Let the world know what is going on, because there are sinister things going on, and they don't want anybody to talk. And anytime you speak, they take you down to the courts and they want to jail you. So people need to speak up. Without fear, they need to stand up and speak. Yeah.
Today you're calling me gonna tell me that I cannot nonsense. That's disrespectful.
Yeah, if
no mama, no pussy. No mama, no pussy. No mama, no pussy.
No mama, no pussy.
It's time we can pray and save Dominica. This is not about red and blue and whatever color you want to pick. This is about our future, guys. This is about our future.
Only thing, the only revenue, guess what happened? The only revenues or the only asset that's bringing revenue to Dom right now is the sale passport. That ends, that's it. The tourism is dead. Our culture is dead. The productive sector is doing nothing. Virtually nothing.
2 years after Hurricane Maria, we're hearing about so many billions of dollars all kinds of foreigners are making. It's not a lie that Zampoli filed a lawsuit in the court of New York. Non-Dominican. Requesting how much? Over $7 million in fees from the sale of Dominican passports. So what are the Dominicans benefiting?
I was a pro farmer. People, this is Dominica we're talking about, man. Now I see my people, farmers, give up their farm and go in and line up for money. People, it hurt my heart.
Shame.
While in America, I go to Dominica, I plant 5 acres of avocado, 40 feet apart. I planted 6 acres of cocoa.
No markets.
Hurricane damage, everything. My spirit don't break. I steal the land because I need you, man, I'm telling you. Yeah. I don't want to stay in America. I cannot do nothing for Dominica in America. I'm a farmer.
Why is it those of us that in the country right now requiring, because yes, they're giving us house. You can pay your light bill, you can pay the water bill. Look in the middle of the month, you know how the bill is going to pay already.
But just because I get that doesn't mean I go into hide in a corner and I cannot come and say when things wrong and when things not right. No, nobody cannot buy Roslyn.
Life come worse for me than before because of the way scary organizing the money. Under scary administration is when I'm more poor. Mm. I like a worm in the soil.
Today, you have Hurricane Maria and everybody is broke. Everybody, because we stayed for what, 18 years, 17 years through under a government where the economy is plunging down, and nobody will talk about economy, how they're going to grow the economy and how they're going to make our life better, except for the opposition people that are talking about how they're going to grow the economy and how they're going to fix. My God, they alone gives us hope, the opposition people. The government doesn't give us hope.
Vince Anderson grew up on the radio and say the amount of million we get. I cannot believe a liberal. I cannot believe a liberal point in Dominica. The man not democratic.
They want to be millionaires. They want to have all the country money. And they want to have the people poor so that you can come and beg them. So when you cannot buy meat now, you have to go to them and tell them, you can't buy meat, but you buy the water, but you buy the juice. That is how they want to live in a country. How can people be independent in that country? And they want to spend another 5 years again to oppress the people. That is a shame. So the world have to see. The world have to see how we live in Dominica.
Take it from me. Scared must go. DLP must run.
fire upon them.
The other want to ask from you exactly what party in which you are from. Thank you, sir.
Yes.
20 years of the Labour Party. 20 years of Skerrit running Dominica. The Lyle Skerrit. 20 years we have a cost of living that is destroying Dominica. You mean to tell me $4.50 per hour and $200 shopping? It is month-end. So sad for us in Dominica. The world have to know how we're living in this crisis in Dominica. The world must know what is happening, and somebody have to put it out. $200 shopping month-end in Dominica. $4.50 per hour. In Antigua, $7.50. In St. Kitts, $8.50. And see what I have. I want the world to see what I have for my $200. That is a box of juice. That is a breeze for $10. $10 easy. We deliver easy currency in the Caribbean, in Dominica. Here we have some chips for children. Here we have $10 grapes. We have people foreign grapes in the European countries in Guadeloupe next door to us. Here we have 2 bottles of water. One is Tropiton water, Dominica manufactured water. Jamaica manufactured water. The Jamaica water is $1.90. They have to export it from Jamaica. They have to import it in Dominica with custom duty, $1.90. And we have the Dominica manufactured water without paying tax on the port, $3. $3 for it. See the cost of living. See how we're living in Dominica. Our own manufacturing products are more expensive than an import product. How can a country move forward? How can that country go somewhere in that world? The Prime Minister not seeing that. But he's saying to give you $2,000, he's saying you to bribe you in all different ways and have a $4.50 in our pocket. That is why our people have been leaving Dominica. They have no choice but to leave the country. They are running us out of our country to go and work in Antigua for $8, for $7.50 an hour. In St. Kitts, we are all about the Caribbean. Dominica just will be empty under that lying Prime Minister. That is why we have to take them out. There we have that juice there again. That juice. There we have the sugar. Eh? $2.43. The world have to see what is happening. Macaroni, $3. The world have to see. $5. $5 for this. That is about $6. A Colgate for you to brush your teeth. A Colgate so that your mouth won't smell. $14 for that. Eh? $14, the world, eh? The people, my people in America, my loving people in America, $14, eh? We have a corned beef for $10, eh? One corned beef for $10, $4.50 per hour, right? You need 3 hours of work to buy one corned beef. You have a mackerel for $7, one mackerel for seven something, almost $8. Right? You need 2 hours of work in Dominica for you to buy a mackerel. You have milk, $5.95. 2 hours of work to buy just a little handful of milk in Dominica. You have lentils, $4.80. You need 2 hours of work for you to buy that amount of lentils in Dominica. You have milk again. You have a soap, which is $2. $2. You have the sardine. One sardine for $5 in Dominica. Ah, Maguesa. One sardine for $5. How can we pay for one sardine? Where we will go in that country? Don't talk to the Prime Minister about bringing down tax on the port. When you bring down tax on the port for basic needs, that's going to be cheaper. We're going to have more money in our pocket. We're going to have change. We're going to be able to buy more. Here we have tuna. Another $5 again. Tuna. Baked beans. Another $4 again. You see, Vienna sausage, $3. How much you buy in it in America? How much you buy in it in America and the rest of the country in the Caribbean? Eh? A lot of these things there are cheaper in St. Lucia, are cheaper in Trinidad. They, where it is, the passage is much longer and it is cheaper. That's how they are destroying us too. Tell me, $200 shopping, $4.50 per hour. How can you live in a country like that? You must leave the country. I do not have meat. There is no chicken. There is no rice. There is no red beans. They're missing the entire supermarket for me. All right, how can you live? And you have children. How can you leave boxes empty? $200 shopping. I want the world to see. $200. How can we live like that? Show the world. There is the receipt. I'm not lying. There is the receipt. Show the world the receipt. Look at the shopping. Look all the items and their prices. You know? How can you live in a country like that? And the Prime Minister wants to make the whole thing that Dominica is good. Everything is happening all right. They want to be millionaires. They want to have all the country money. And they want to have the people poor. So that you could come and beg them. So when you cannot buy meat now, you have to go to them and tell them, you can't buy meat, but you buy the water, but you buy the juice. That is how they want you to live in a country. How can people be independent in that country? And they want to set them another 5 years again to oppress the people. That is a shame, so the world have to see. The world have to see how we live in Dominica. How we are living. Things they are getting for nothing. Things they are buying in packets and we have to buy it in single. In a country like that. So if you're working for $4.50 minimum wage, you do just cut off your shopping for $200, you cannot afford the rest. You have a house rent to pay for $800 minimum for a two-bedroom house. A single bedroom, you might get it for $500 EC. This is about just about your salary. So how can you live in a country like that? People living, they're going to Antigua. They're going to St. Kitts. They're saving money. They're paying their rent. You in your own country, you cannot even do a proper shopping. Which means you cannot save. And you live in your country, going next door in the same Caribbean country, you can save. You can send money for your family. You can come back to Dominica and build a house, buy a vehicle, and you in your country, you are not paying rent. 25 years you are at your mother home. 40 years you have 3 children, 2 children at your mother home. Huh? That is the kind of life people should be living in a country under that line, Prime Minister. And we have some failure, the failure Daru, and some failure ministers. Cannot go in the House and Parliament and debate against Kerry so that they could bring down the tax on the people so they could people could breathe. Eh? It's safe for them to go and they have to go and they will go.
A 9-year-old boy talking to his father. Daddy, what is politics? The boy asks a pertinent question. Father had to think now to give him a pertinent answer. What is politics? Father Hotty Brains, he says, son, let me put it this way. I have to provide for you. So I am the capitalist. You are the people. Your mother does keep the money. She is the government. The babysitter is the working class. And your baby brother is the future. You understand? Well, the boy couldn't put that jigsaw puzzle together. He said, yeah, I think so. He's gone to bed and he's sleeping. While he's sleeping, he hear a little baby brother crying. He went and peep in the room and see the diaper in a mess. So he tried to communicate with the mother. Mommy sung asleep. He decided not to disturb she. He gone to the babysitter. When he watching the room, daddy having an affair with the babysitter. He decided not to disturb them either. So he go and tuck away in bed and he sleep. In the morning, he get up, they having breakfast. He said, Dad, I think I know what is politics. He said, good, tell me in your own small way, what is politics? He said, well, Dad, it's something like this. While the government is asleep, the capitalists cruise the working class. The people are ignored while the future is in deep shit.
The United States has conducted an operation that killed Osama bin Laden.
Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi is dead.
The United States launched a targeted operation against that compound.
They did a lot of shooting, and they did a lot of blasting, even not going through the front door. You know, you think you go through the door. If you're a normal person, you say, knock, knock, may I come in?
After a firefight, they killed Osama bin Laden and took custody of his body.
He died like a dog.
But his death does not mark the end of our effort.
A beautiful dog, a talented dog.
We give thanks for the men who carried out this operation.
And I don't get any credit for this, but that's okay. I never do. But here we are.
May God bless you, and may God bless the United States of America.
And I'm writing a book. Well, there were 12 books. All did very well.
I miss Mom Goldberg.
Look, I understand that some Vincentians and Grenadians and Guyanese, a whole plane load of them arrived, sent down from the United States. And we don't know when our people, Dominican self, will start to come down. Because me and you know that half of our Dominicans outside, they don't have papers in the United States. They don't have papers. And every morning when you see Trump wake up in his tantrum, they're in their basement. 2 days they can't come out in the basement. Because they're not legal in the United States and they cannot come down.
If he doesn't care, yeah.